Are you frustrated because you're trying to figure out the new chart of account interface in QuickBooks Online? Well, then you should watch this emergency update because there has just been a change to the chart of account interface in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Don't be intimidated. Don't be fooled. Everything in the following video about chart of accounts is still there. You see, the old interface that just changed was there for many years. And when you clicked to open a new account window, you would first get the choice of account type. And based on that choice, you would get a different pull-down list for the detail type, which was like the subtype. And only after choosing both of those types were you able to put in your account name. Everything now is the same, it just looks different, so don't be fooled. The new interface has the same thing. When you click the green button in the top right, instead of that window you saw a moment ago, you instead see a side panel open up with these little circles. And these little circles are now what we call the new general category, which means all you have to do differently from before is first choose one of the general categories of the account that you're about to add. Then everything else will appear one by one. For example, if you choose to click the circle of assets, what you will see is the account type assets or the account types that are under that general category. And when you click the pull down, those are the same account types that you had the choice of in the previous interface. They're simply listed under the category of assets. And when they say listed under, it means the chart of accounts lists them inside that category and keeps all the accounts in the same category together. So the only difference is you would first choose one of the circles on top, then you would choose your account type. Of course, if you choose a different circle, then a different set of account type choices will appear under the first pull-down. And the account type list will change if you choose a different general category. But don't worry, those are the same account types under that category. Now, the detail type will change based on the account type that you chose, just like it did a moment ago when you saw the old interface. And those are the same detail types under that account type category, just like it would be in the old interface. So, the old Enter New Account window used to look like this, and we're going to try right now to see if I can actually enter this exact account in the new interface. Bank type of account, detail is cash on hand, and the name is cash in bank, and we'll see what it looks like on the list when I use the new interface. So here in QuickBooks Online, I click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, then I click New. Now when I click New, I get these choices of circles on the top right, and these are the general categories that my account will fall under. This is the only new piece of information that I have to choose when putting in a new account. But it should be apparent what category the account is in. For example, based on our name, I'm sure that it's a bank type of account. And once I choose that circle, when I click the pull down, I get bank type of accounts, and these are the existing accounts that were already on the list before I initiated this video. So if I click bank type of accounts, that's the account type under here. If I clicked another general category, I would certainly get more choices under that general category. But under the bank category, there's only one bank type of accounts, and these are the ones I already have. So I know that the general type is bank account, and where it says tax form selection, that simply means detail type, because it might help you when placing the account numbers on a tax form. So in the prior example, the detail type was cash on hand, and the account name was cash in bank. A bit silly, but that's our example. Okay, so we have the general category, and then remember, these are the ones that are already, these are the accounts that are on the list already. This is the name of the account type that you put. And then, of course, detail type means tax form selection. It's the same thing as before. And when you click save, now you see what they mean by category under, because you can see cash in bank is this detail type, and that's how it's listed in the chart of accounts. In closing, I would like to make a solemn promise to all my students that soon I will have an updated video that shows your new interface in your course for the video that shows the chart of accounts. Until then, please use the video that follows this one and just remember how the interface now works so that you can quickly and easily and smoothly put in your chart of accounts. And if you don't yet know what the chart of accounts is, just watch the following video, but put everything in the way I showed you here. Thank you so much for your patience, and the new videos are coming soon.